Hello, Janice.
Hello, Anthony.
Today, let's talk about four reasons to start home buying this spring. Isn't it nice? Isn't it nice that the winter finally seems to be over?
It's spring is like saying, you made it. You made it through the winter. We can do this. I love it.
Actually, I just realized by the time this airs, it'll be more like summer, but whatever.
That's okay. You know what? It's spring-ish.
Yeah. All right. So spring is traditionally one of the busiest home buying seasons. So we'll go over a few reasons why you may want to start shopping for a home this spring. All right. So first, number one, why is it kind of traditionally a busy home shopping season? It has to do with the school years. So families with kids, right, make up a big percentage of home buyers. Most home buyers, not all, but most are families with kids. So they tend to move or relocate according to the school year, which means, think about it. You want to move in the middle, in the summer, because you don't want to disrupt your kids and, you know, what, shift them in the middle of the school year. Does that make sense?
Oh, absolutely. It's so much easier to do it in the summer and they start the school year with everyone else.
Yep.
It is absolutely the easiest thing to do when you're trying to move your house and your family.
So think about it. If you want to be in your new house at the very latest, what, July or August, maybe even sooner than that, depending on what the school district's rules are, because you might not be eligible to go to your local school unless you've been there for X number of weeks or months, right?
Right.
So if you need to close and be in your new place by, let's say, July, and you let's just back it out, it takes 30 days minimum to close, let's say 60. So now you're in June, May. That means you should be on the market and looking, you know, late March, maybe April, getting your offer in, all that good stuff. Does that timeline work out?
It does. And I mean, worst case, there's still time now in, you know, May and June, if you have to, still getting in before that. But most start around what, the 1st of September or late August.
Right.
But yeah, it's so much easier just in the summer and get it over with before the school starts. They start with the other kids. Absolutely. Cool.
All right. So that's why, or that's one of the reasons why spring is a hot home buying season. The other reason is because it has to do with inspections, repairs, and renovations. And the bottom line is all of those things are easier to do when the weather's nice.
Absolutely. Everything's better when the weather's nice.
So repairs and renovations, I think that's kind of obvious. You don't want I'll give you the city example and maybe you can give me the suburb example.
Yeah.
In the city example, you know, getting the truck to park out front for your renovation guys, that can be a pain if there's, parking spots plowed snow is blocking a lot of parking spots, right? That happens in the city a lot. You also don't want, you know, workmen tramping around your apartment in sloshy, sludgy, you know, boots and whatnot. I mean, just, you know, if it can be avoided. And there's some stuff you can't do when, you know, pipes freezing and windows too cold, things like that. So that's the city perspective. Is it pretty much the same in the burbs?
Oh, it's exactly the same. Yeah. Yes. Because you're parking right out front, you're coming in and it melts. It's a messy, melty, mess. But on the, you also, you know, you ever seen a yard that normally looks maybe really trashy and there's stuff all over and it's not that great?
Yeah.
And it's covered in snow. It looks beautiful. Right? I've seen this before. I'm like, wow, their yard finally looks amazing because it's covered in this beautiful white snow. You're not going to see that if you're looking at a house in the middle of winter. You see this, you know, beautiful white snow and then it melts and you're like, wow, we got a lot of work.
I kind of feel like it's the opposite for apartments. In the city, buildings can look pretty gloomy and the lack of light can really be accentuated because, you know, having good windows and good sunlight is kind of a premium in Manhattan. So that could be an issue in the danker winter days, whereas everything gets sanitized and looks nicer in fresh sunlight, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. Everything just looks better in the spring and it feels better and you can open the windows, air it out a little bit.
So also inspections, there are certain things, maybe you can speak to this more because it's a suburban thing, that are just harder to check or the inspector might miss if they're masked, like you said, by the snow. Yeah?
Absolutely. And one of the big things is water. What do you have in the spring? Rain. I swear it's been raining every single day since March 1st.
Right.
Now, if you come in to do an inspection, you're going to tell if there's a leak or cracks or a non-working sub pump. I mean, now's the time for that you're going to be able to see those issues. Whereas in the winter and maybe really late summer, it looks dry. Of course it does. There hasn't been any rain. So that's just that's a big thing now that they can look for to thwart any problems later.
Cool. All right. So why start home buying or home shopping this spring. According to a U.S. Home Price Insights reports, prices are going to be going up, essentially. Let's see here. Prices have appreciated, have gone up 4.4% over the past 12 months. And this report, at least, predicts that they will continue going up to about by about 4.6% over the next year. So, you know, you want to buy lower, so maybe get in on it now. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. But I think the flip side of that is, and if you're not really ready and you're looking that at that 0.2 percentage point of, you know what, I'll wait one more year, I save up. Yeah. Yes, I'll be paying 0.2% more, but might be a better investment next year. So you weigh it out as we talk about all the time.
No. You'll be paying 4.6 more next year.
So it's going to go up. Well,
rate of increase is still will increase, but the increase will be 4.6.
Okay. So still, wait, I'm like, math. We both know better on these podcasts to make Janice do math. But seriously though, you look at that, but yeah, wait, if rates are going to go up.
But your point remains valid. 4% on a purchase price is a lot of money, but if you're not ready, you're not ready. So just make sure you're ready before you jump in.
Yes.
And so the final reason to start home shopping this spring is that mortgage rates are also projected to increase, and that can be huge because even the slightest, the seemingly smallest increase in your mortgage rate can have a big impact over the 20 or 30 years that you'll be paying it. So the Freddie Mac's primary mortgage market survey says that interest rates for 30-year fixed mortgages came in at 4.4% recently, but most experts are predicting that it'll rise over the next 12 months. So that might be a good reason to pull the trigger now. Yeah,
absolutely.
So I actually have a bit of a contrarian view on this in that I'm okay with mortgage rates going up and I care a lot more about home purchase prices. And I'll give you an example. So let's say the home that you're interested in is at like $200,000 and mortgage rates are at 4%. And I'm using really round kind of fake numbers.
Right.
But let's say mortgage rates skyrocket to 5%, maybe even 6%, right? Usually, theoretically, what will happen is that the home prices will either flatten or even probably go down a bit to reflect that increased carrying cost from the higher mortgage rates, right? So maybe now the house you want will go down to like 175, maybe if you're lucky, 150. That's kind of ridiculous, but yeah, something like that. So my theory is that buying low, even at a high mortgage rate, is better because you can never change your purchase price. That's locked once you do it. But you can always refinance your mortgage, right?
Very true.
Maybe it was a temporary blip and then maybe the government will, whatever they do, you know, tinker with the interest rates and it'll slowly sag back down to 4% in 3 or 4 years. Who knows? Then you can refinance and get the best of both worlds. So
that's a very good point.
Yeah. We'll see.
We'll see how it plays out. But yeah. Yes. Yeah. That's, I mean, when you think about it, when everything starts going up, you have to account for that when you're planning out your monthly expenses.
Very true. All right. So that's it. Those are our four reasons to start home buying this spring. Thanks for listening. And, if you want, maybe now's a good time to get started. Janice, do you have anything to add?
I don't. You can see all the signs going in all over the place right now. I mean, the market seems to be very hot.
Cool. All right. Thanks for listening. And thank you, Janice. Talk to you next time.
Talk soon.
Bye now.